Summer Valley FM. For the next half an hour, we're going flying, helicopter flying. Getting a bit nervous, hanging out my first lesson in a helicopter up at Staverton Airfield with JK Helicopter Training. In the music mix in the next half an hour, some flying songs from Tom Petty and Heartbreakers, Red Hot Chili Peppers, Randy Crawford, R. Kelly believes he can fly, and here's Lenny Kravitz.
This is the Bailey Brunch.
I wish that I could fly into the sky, so very high, just like a dragonfly. I'd fly above the trees, over the seas, in all degrees, to anywhere I please. Oh, I want to get away. I wanna fly away. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I want to get away. I wanna fly away. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Let's go and see the stars.
Come up to Staverton Airfield, which is in Gloucestershire, and I'm meeting James Kenwright. Good morning, James.
Good morning.
Are you Captain James? I am
Captain James Kenwright for today.
Very good. Well, James has been flying helicopters for more than 30 years as an instructor, and how many students have you got through training in that time, do you reckon, James?
Hundreds, but I've stopped counting about 20 years ago.
What's the satisfaction to you in training people? They've got a dream to fly, and you make the dream happen.
It's fascinating taking somebody who's had a picture of a helicopter in their bedroom on the wall as a child and realizing their dreams. And we see ourselves like painters with a blank canvas. We put all the paint on and the images start to take shape. And it's a wonderful thing to see somebody going off and flying with skills that you've taught them. It's very satisfying because the whole thing is very clever, really, being able to fly an aircraft in the sky, particularly a helicopter.
Well, you've kindly offered to give me a taste of that feeling, and I'll let you into a secret. When I was a little kid, 8, 9, 10 years old, there's a black and white thing on the telly called Whirly Birds. Did you ever watch Whirly Birds from America? There were two pilots.
Yeah.
It was Chuck and PT, and they used to go off and rescue people.
I was watching the other channel. I was watching Airwolf.
or Airwolf. There's something as a glimmer, as a child, it's stuck in my mind.
Yeah. Well, it often is people's dreams to do something like this. And we are realising people's dreams, so we have a great responsibility. And it's uncommon for somebody to come to us who can't actually do it. It just may take more training and more hours.
What sort of skills, I mean, riding a bike or something like this, everyday stuff, what sort of skills?
There are a couple of indicators. One indicator which we ask for is, do you ride motorbikes?
Oh, okay.
Because to ride a motorbike, you'd have to have a good feel for machinery and space, time and motion. Otherwise, you'd be coming off all the time.
Sure.
Or remote control helicopter flying. But you can never tell by looking at somebody. Somebody could be incredibly sporty and have trouble with it, where there could be somebody who's never does any sport at all and watches a lot of television and is just a natural. So you can never tell until you get somebody on the controls, but you can normally tell quite quickly.
I've watched one of the two of these videos you can see on YouTube now, how to fly a helicopter, and you've obviously got to do different things with all your limbs. You've got your feet doing one thing, you've got both hands on different controls. So,
well, that's a very interesting point, because by about 20 hours of flight training, you will be able to fly a helicopter, hover it, land it, pick it up, and take off without even thinking about what you're doing. You'll just do it naturally. So if you want to go from A to B, you just think about that and it just will happen.
Would a drummer be good at flying a helicopter? Because they have to do all different things with their different limbs, don't they?
You know, all these things will definitely help you. In fact, I've learned to play the drums recently, having been a helicopter pilot.
Wow.
And I am told that I picked it up quite quickly, as you're doing lots of different things at once.
Well, Bailey Brunch today is with Captain James Kenwright at JK Helicopter Training up at Staverton Airfield. It's about half an hour north of Bristol up the M5. And James is obviously a skilled helicopter pilot, but now he's a drummer too, easily teaching his brain to work all four limbs so they do different things in different directions at the same time. What type of people do you see coming through? What about age range and their motives for flying?
It's right across the board. The younger ones are thinking about doing it as a career, but we have a lot of people in their 30s, 40s and 50s. In fact, we put somebody through recently who's 65, and I did a test on somebody recently who is 80.
So you can teach an old dog new tricks then?
Yeah, well, he flew very, very well at 80. I think a lot of people think themselves into old age. I think if you're able-bodied and you're healthy, you can do anything at any age. And this is a very interesting thing to do, because it's not just about learning to fly helicopters. You're learning about meteorology, you're learning about engines, you're seeing the world at its best from an altitude. You get a lot of good other things coming out of learning to fly.
I'm learning to fly around the clouds, but what goes up must come down. I'm learning to fly.
It takes people about 60 to 80 hours to get a license, although the minimums are 45. And we have had people do it in the 50s, but you are learning to fly an aircraft in a three-dimensional world, and you are bombing around on a piece of plastic at 2,000 feet and 100 miles per hour, so it does require a little bit of flight time to get
there. I thought they're made of metal. They're made of plastic, are they?
Well, they are metal and plastic. I was just embellishing a bit
there. And there's a range of experiences people can have here. I mean, I'm just going to have a sort of what you might call a trial lesson. But
I think everybody should do at least a flight just to get the experience of a trial lesson. And that can just be a 30-minute flight. So we have two directions with what we offer here, and that is a PPL license, which is a life-changing experience for people, or just a 30-minute or 45-minute trial lesson, and then it's just sort of see whether they can hover and how long are they can hover for. Take the hover challenge.
The hover.
Anything more than 5 seconds is more than luck. So you've got, it will have some skill and talent there if you last more than 5 seconds on our hover challenge.
There's a challenge. I just have to accept that one.
Yeah, I'm going to put you on the hover challenge. Oh. I'll give you some instruction on our trial lesson, and then at the end of the trial lesson, we'll see how many seconds you can hover for on all three controls.
Before it falls out of the sky.
And anything more than 5 seconds is talent.
Brilliant, James. Well, we'll have a break for some music, and then we'll come back at the aircraft.
Absolutely. And it's all ready to go, fueled up, and we're going to launch off to the north, and it's a lovely day.
I'm getting nervous now. Let's take off here with CLC. I go up, helicopter, then I'm
my gal we're dust. Who would that eat on the dough? And I took the joke, cause they don't go. She just keep dough. I wanna go. I'm in the zone. That's how you look at. I want it more. I need it again. Sorry, get your kid, boy. Chance, deep to number. Nobody's ever been. Now let me show you a shining road. I spit it out. 처음 느낀 낯선 기류 끝에. 내 심장은 온통 never stop. 더 높이 오르고. 늘 궁금했던 하늘까지, yeah.
Down, so it controls our height and altitude.
So anyone who's driven a car will be familiar with a normal handbrake between the seats. That's what James is describing there.
On the end of it, there's a throttle which controls our rotor speed.
Okay, so the one lever does the collective to make you go up and down, and the throttle as well.
Right, so two controls in one.
Okay.
So there are four controls. This one's the cyclic.
Okay, this is the column in front of the
throttle. So if you hear me say stick, I'm talking about the cyclic, okay? And it makes you go in any direction you point it.
That will tip the aircraft in whichever direction you
yes.
nudge it.
And then we have the pedals, which make the aircraft turn left and right in the hover.
Yeah.
And keeps the aircraft in balance and trim in forward flight. Are you comfortable?
Yes, I am.
Yep. Yeah, you're looking very relaxed.
Yeah, I'm enjoying it. Lovely feeling. And you say the visibility, my immediate reaction is there's a glass dome there. Not glass, obviously, it's plastic.
It's a magic carpet. That's the sensation you get when you fly in a helicopter.
Wow.
You just feel like you're floating over the countryside.
You can see the two gauges rising, engine speed and rotor speed there.
And the rotor's now getting round, it's about 450 miles per hour.
Is it?
Here we go, it's raising the collective.
Okay.
We're now going to depart the ground, and now we're in the hover.
Well, already airborne.
Oh, that's the arm.
Weightless, okay. Absolutely brilliant. Yeah,
left pedal turn. And now we're taxiing out to the takeoff point.
I'm hooked. Yeah, 10 seconds. Absolutely magical.
And you see what I mean by this magic carpet?
Yeah.
Feel, you're floating around.
We're cruising over the grass of the runway, about only 10 feet above the ground now. I'm not flying this, of course, this is James. I'm having a lovely little passenger ride at the moment.
Cossier 4, it's part of the West, come up and take it. And now we're transitioning into full flight, crossing the active runway. Off we go.
Fly away.
But up here, it looks like we're almost hovering, but we are actually going 80 miles per hour.
Wow.
And we'll level off at about 1,000 feet at 75 knots, and then we're going to get you on the controls.
Oh dear.
You have the cyclic now, just follow me through. If I push it forward a little bit, you can see it, you're going to go faster. Do you see it? You're at 75 knots there?
Yes.
Now it's going to 80, we want to bring the speed off a bit, bring it back a little bit. Very sensitive though.
Very sensitive. I've now got the control of the cyclic in my hand here.
I use the compass as a reference point for your attitude. When I say attitude, I mean nose position.
Yeah.
So just keep that compass on the horizon now.
Yep.
The nose goes up, push it forward a bit, the nose goes down, bring it back a bit. Just so you keep the airspeed constant at
75
knots is what we want.
Alright, I'll push it forward.
If you keep the nose still, your airspeed still, which is what we want. That's good. Alright.
Okay, we're doing 70 knots, I've got the cyclic, I'm now flying it, really.
Now remember, if you want to get rid of the control, just say you have control.
Yes, it's very subtle, isn't it? I'm just pushing gently forward, and it's at 65 knots now, so I want to increase it slightly.
Yeah, that's it, just let the nose down, push it forward a tiny bit, and then hold the attitude, hold the nose position, then your airspeed will stay the same. Doing very well, by the way, very well. If I'm off the controls, it means you're doing very well.
Yeah, I'm feeling quite nervous about it. It's funny, it's not like the balloon, but just you've got to keep flying it the whole time.
And left turn now.
You want me to turn left?
Yep, so a little bit of left bank. Now just hold that left bank, and we're going to go all the way around, a little bit more left.
I'm doing left with the cyclic, yeah?
Yep, left on the cyclic, yep. Because that's how we turn, we don't turn with the pedals, just on the cyclic.
Okay.
Keep the compass at the same height, you're doing a fantastic job.
So I'm turning it left?
You probably think I'm just saying this, but actually you do have aptitude.
Okay, that's smart. I don't know, I'm really enjoying it, I must say.
Yeah, you're doing very well.
Gently turning left now.
Keep it coming now, all the way around to the left. As you can see, I now take my feet off the pedals, and I take my hand off the collective, and I'm not flying the aircraft at all. So you can see that you're flying the helicopter by yourself, right?
Apparently I am, yes.
I'm going to put my feet back on the pedals.
We've come through more than 90 degrees left now. Is that Gloucester ahead of us now?
Yeah, just roll out towards Gloucester.
Okay, I'm heading straight for Gloucester. Fantastic visibility today, we can see over the Malvern Hills, across into Wales.
Now the Malvern Hills are very...
with the helicopter traffic?
Very dramatic.
70 knots.
That's good.
A little bit of buffeting, is that the wind or is that...
A little bit of wind, yeah. A little bit of wind. I have control.
Okay.
We're going to walk back towards the airfield and look at some hovering. We're going to put you to the hover challenge.
Hover challenge.
Yep.
What a wonderful machine, this is just magical. I mean, we're now cruising over the fields, banking left through a little gap between the trees.
It's dream stuff, isn't it?
This aircraft, you're part of this aircraft, James, aren't you? The way you're, the way you're doing what you wanted.
You had to wear it like a glove. And you don't need thousands of hours to fly it.
One day I'll fly away. Leave your love. What more can your love do for me? When will love be through with me?
7 now and see our reflection in the water.
300 feet, 1018. I think, you know, we all think we're going to make it to 90-something, but we're not always here forever, are we? And I think it's important to do interesting stuff.
There is a sort of live for today, and certainly at the moment, with everything going on in the world. We've had the virus, we've got the war in Ukraine at the moment, and there's a lot of do it now, live now, because you never know what tomorrow holds for you.
Yeah, and I think anybody who's experienced loss realises that. But a lot of people do think they'll be here forever, and I think it's important to do interesting stuff.
Yeah.
And this is certainly an interesting thing to do. Here we are, Rob. You've got the controls again. Would you like the controls?
I have controls.
And just put your feet on the pedals. Keep the attitude the same, then your airspeed will stay the same. Airport's on the nose. Okay, Captain, a little bit faster. Let's go up to 75 knots. There we are. It takes a little while for the airspeed to come on. There's a bit of a lag. That's good. Very good. You happy?
Yeah, I'm happy.
Okay.
I wasn't too subtle on the pedal.
Okay, I have control.
Okay, back again.
So, to be a good pilot, you need to be very spatially aware.
Yeah.
We're now in an inside the aerodrome area, and keep a good lookout.
So we're now over the roughy part of the airfield. Gently down, James is flying it at the moment.
So we're now approaching the hover. 30 feet, 20 feet, 10 feet, and now just raising the collective, a little bit of left pedal. Stabilizing the aircraft, and now we are in the hover.
Okay.
Now, Rob, just keep your feet on the pedals there, and just apply a little bit of right pedal, and then a bit of left pedal. Put a bit of left pedal in now. That's it. Now a little bit of right. Have a little play with those.
James is hovering the aircraft, a few feet off the ground, I'm going left.
And Rob's got the pedals.
And Rob's got the pedals, I'm going to go right pedal now.
Yeah.
Left to the right.
We're trying to hover. When the nose goes up, you've got to go forward, back to the middle.
Oh, I can.
If the aircraft goes to the right, you've got to go left, back to the middle, opposite central lines. Like if you were balancing on top of a football with your feet, you've got to keep shuffling, don't you? You have to keep moving.
Okay.
So just take the cyclic now, and you must look outside, okay?
Yep, and looking at outside.
Try and keep this spot, which I call the sweet spot. That's the spot where it wants to hover, so try and stay on the hover spot. But you've got to crisscross. You got it now? Okay, you have control.
Okay, I have control.
That's good, you're capturing the feeling there, that's good. Forward, 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 then back to the middle. There they are, you've got it now, look at that, that's good.
Yeah, I think I'll get it.
There, you see, that's the feeling, that's great, because now you've captured the feeling, you know what it feels like to get there.
Well, you're getting the hang of it now.
That's excellent.
We're hovering fairly steadily.
Now, Rob, we're doing the hover challenge.
The hover challenge, no
right. Just take the pedals, collective. All three controls. And anything more than 5 seconds is very good. Keep it to the left a bit. I'll take the control of it if it goes a little bit nuts. You ready?
Yep.
Go. 3, 4, 5 seconds. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. I've got it. 12 seconds. Well done. That's really, really good. There you go.
What a funny feeling that is.
Okay, give you one more go, see if you can beat 12 seconds with all three controls. So Rob's on the controls, all three controls. In 3, 2, 1, it's got to be 12 seconds, go! 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, I have control.
What a thrill, that was fantastic, James.
And then Rob, if you just lower the collective a little bit, there we are, we're coming down now, approaching the ground. Come down a little bit more.
You're on the ground, do you? Go down.
Come down a little bit more. I think, Rob, you're so good, we're going to get you to do a landing on the grass. So come down a bit more. Don't drop it, just let it keep coming down. Don't push it onto the ground. Lower the lever a bit more. Lower the collective a bit more. 3, 2, 1, and ground contact.
I've made the landing, I've landed.
The Eagle has landed.
I have landed a helicopter.
I have control, just let go of the collective now, that's it.
Fantastic. I think you got me hooked there, mate.
It's exciting though, isn't it?
Oh, my heart rate is just coming down. Wow, what an experience.
I used to think that I could not go on.
life was nothing but an awful song. But now I know the meaning of true love. I'm leaning on the everlasting arms. If I can see it, then I can do. If I just believe it, there's nothing to it. I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the sky. I think about it every night and day. Spread my wings and fly away. I believe I can soar. I see me running through that open door. I believe I can fly. I believe I can fly. See, I was on the verge of breaking down. Sometimes silence can seem so loud. But first I know it starts inside of me. Oh, oh, if I can see it, then I can be it. If I just believe it, there's nothing to it. I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the sky. I think about it every night and day. Spread my wings and fly away. I believe I can soar. I see me running through that open door. I believe I can fly. I believe I can fly. Oh, I believe I can fly.
I believe.
winding down the rotors there. You'll believe you can fly if you're good to have a go at that. Then contact James Kenwright. James, thank you so much. You're so patient with me. If you're interested in helicopter training, and it's not just going for your license, you can do one-off trial lessons for birthday or anniversary gifts. You can get vouchers for people. It starts at just over £200 for a trial lesson and goes up from there. Have a look at the website. It's jkhelicoptertraining.com, jkhelicoptertraining.com, or drop James a line. He is James at jkhelicoptertraining.com. He'll certainly make you believe you can fly.
This is the Bailey Brunch.